somebody's corridor, and by the time you come out of the corridor, in another street, you know. So while I was going, I was hearing the jingle on AIT, and something just told me, very quiet something. It just said, "Pat, this is who you are. This is who you are. If you follow it, life is beautiful for you." I get it. I just kept it to myself. So I can lay hands on you. You don't hear. The Spirit of God don't tell you things. Holy Spirit should begin to tell you things now. Do you understand?
Yes.
Yes. If Holy Spirit is not telling you something now, you have to be asking when you're praying. You say, "Holy Spirit, direct me. Holy Spirit, teach me. Holy Spirit, tell me." Because if you ask me right now, I will tell you that the Holy Spirit whispered to me, as long as I were, that Pat, this is the path to life for you. So when people are telling me otherwise, I kept the information that the Holy Spirit told me. I knew that this must be God. However, you can see that that came out of me without even being in the university. That means that this is really who I am. If I pursue it, that's fine. But I made up my mind, I pursue it. I finished the school. I finished time, of course, getting ready to go do masters, getting ready to go and do. Then I'm asking myself, now that I know what I want to do, it's easier for me to say, this is what I want to do for my masters, so that I can help younger people come in behind. But till then, this is who I am today. And already I'm asking the Holy Spirit to tell me what is next for me. Thank you. Let me now take you back to how I started. I told you I was born in the Bible. Yes?
Yes.
I was to learn the Yoruba language. Yes?
Yes.
I came to Lagos to finish my school. Right?
Yeah.
That's the journey of life. Some of you, what you need to make up your life is here in Yeshua College. And if you don't pick it before you go, it might affect the next phase. So I know it's some first see our opportunity, some people are graduating, but for those of us that see our opportunity, learn what you need to learn now. Pick it, because it will be another instrument for the next phase of your life. And before we finished in Yabate, it was just 3 years. I met Benga, Ayo, Michael, everybody in Midaiku right now. And we started singing together. And they said, "Okay, Pat, give us a song." And we composed the song, and that song came out. So it's very easy for me because I understand the two, I can flip the two languages. There was an influence of that language in my career. Because it's art, you know, language, the art and all that. Everything married together. And we did this song 2004 before. Yeah, nobody heard about it. But in 2008, the song just did. And immediately, once that walk just comes out, the rest is just, other doors just begin to open. So you can see the journey. But I know some of you say, "Daddy, why did you bomb me in America? Daddy, why did you bomb me in London?" In fact, I used to say that before. I said, "Thank you, Daddy, for bombing and giving birth to me in Nigeria." Because once I entered that America, doors just open. I just walk in. Because it's coming from Africa. Yes. Even the Americans, that's the response. Because of what? I made up my mind about what I want to do, and those doors are opening. When the man that did Facebook, did you hear about that? When he came to Nigeria, did he come? Did they open the border for him to enter? It doesn't matter where you are. The most important thing is where you are going. Yes. Hold on to your dream. Hold it. If you have opportunity to know, just hold on to it. Before you know it, heaven gone will be the. They said the sky is the limit. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you.
All right. Sit down. God bless you. If you have